In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software, Infinite Algebra 1, Free Worksheet, Variable and Verbal Expressions. Our directions in this first part are to write each as an algebraic expression. Now, an algebraic expression only contains numbers and operations. So jumping into number 1, we're to write algebraically the difference of 10 and 5. Now, when you see the word difference, think subtraction. So we're going to be taking 10 and subtracting 5 from it. So this will be 10 minus 5, the difference of 10 and 5. On to number 2, we have the quotient of 14 and 7. Quotient, think division. So we're going to start with the first number and divide that second number. So 14 over 7. 14 divided by 7. For number 3, it says u, which is a variable, so it represents some number or expression, but we have u decreased by 17. So remember, decreased, think subtraction, and u decreased by 17. We're going to have u, and we'll take away 17. U decreased by 17, u minus 17. For number 4, we have half of 14. So we know in order to create half of something, we just divide it by 2. So half of 14 will be 14 over 2, or 14 divided by 2. For number 5, we have x increased by 6. So increasing, think addition. So x is our variable, so some number or some expression x, we're going to be increasing that by 6. X plus 6. For number 6, we have the product of x and 7. So product, think multiply, and we can also write multiplying as a dot in between those two numbers or variables. So x times 7, the product of x and 7. For number 7, we have the sum of q and 8. So sum, think addition. Q is our variable, and we're adding that to the number 8. Q plus 8, the sum of q and 8. For number 8, we have 6 squared. So we're taking our number 6 and multiplying it by itself. 6 times 6, or 6 squared. 6 to the power of 2. And number 9, we have twice of q. So this isn't q squared, so we're not taking q and raising it to a power of 2. However, we have twice q. That's the same as taking q and doubling it. So 2 times q, or 2q. 2 times q is twice of q. The product of 8 and 12, that's the result of multiplying two numbers. So we'll be multiplying 8 and 12. 8 times 12. For number 11, we have the quotient of 18 and n. The quotient is the result of dividing numbers. So we're dividing 18 by n. So the quotient of 18 and n will be 18 over n. And lastly for this section, number 12. In number 12, we have n cubed. So that's n times n times n, or simply n to the power of 3, n cubed. We're going to be writing each as a verbal expression. So now we're taking the algebraic expression and turning it into a verbal expression. And there's many different answers for these, so feel free to write any that I mention, or think of one on your own. So in number 13, we have x divided by 2. We could write it as that, we could write it as the quotient of x and 2, or we could write it as half, because we're taking x and dividing it in half. So we're going to have half of x. For number 14, we have a plus 9, or the sum of a and 9. We could also write this as a increased by 9. But the sum of a and 9 is also another reasonable verbal expression. In number 15, we have 19 minus 3. So we can say this as 19 decreased by 3, or the difference of 19 and 3. So I'll write this as the difference of 19 and 3. In 16, we have 5 times n. So this can be written as the product of 5 and n, or 5 times some number n. So I'll write 5 times a number. That's one way of writing it, where the number is something that we represent with a variable n. We could also write this as the product of 5 and n. In 17, that's simply q squared, or q to a power of 2. So I'll write this as q squared. In number 18, we have 40 divided by 5, so we can write it as such. We could also write this one as, remember, when dividing, that is the quotient of 40 and 5. There are a few different answers you can write for each of these, so pick which one you like best. In number 19, we have a divided by 8. You could also write this as the quotient of a and 8, because again, we're dividing and the quotient is the result of dividing. And just how we say half of a number when we divide it by 2, we could say an eighth of a, because we're dividing by 8. But I'll leave this as a divided by 8. In number 20, we have x plus 8. This could also be written as the sum, because the sum is the result of addition. So the sum of x and 8 is another reasonable answer. Either of those would work. In 21, we have n minus 14. So some number, a number, represented by the variable n, minus 14. We could also write this as the difference of n and 14. For number 22, we have 2 squared, or 2 to the power of 2. So I'll write this as 2 squared. Now let's move on to number 23. For number 23, we have 60 divided by 5, which we could write as that, or we could write this as the quotient of 60 and 5. Because when you see division, the result of that is the quotient. So, the quotient of 60 and 5. And then lastly, for this section, number 24, we have some number n times 6. So I'll say a number times 6. And remember, the result of multiplication is a product. So we could also write this as the product of n and 6. Now, in our next section, for numbers 25 through 34, we're actually going to now evaluate each expression. So, in this case, I'm going to write out algebraically and then solve. So, in number 25, we have 5 squared. So, that's equivalent to 5 to the power of 2. And 5 squared, we could also think of as 5 times 5, which I know is equivalent to 25. So 25 is our solution for 25. In 26, we have the product of 8 and 10. So that's going to be 8 multiplied by some value 10. When multiplying, we could also just have parentheses around a single number. So we could have 8 parentheses 10 and then close that parenthesis, 8 times 10. That's equal to 80. 20 decreased by 17, we know we're subtracting. So we're taking the number 20 and decreasing it by 17. So that's 20 minus 17, which will leave us with the number 3. In number 28, we have the quotient of 96 and 8. Here, quotient, think division. So 96 divided by 8. 8 goes into 96 12 times, so 12 is our solution for number 28. For number 29, we have twice the number 6, so that's going to be 2 times 6, or even 6 plus 6, because we have 2 of them. So 2 times 6 will give us the number 12. In number 30, we have 10 less than 17. So we're starting at 17 and decreasing that by 10 because we have 10 less than that original value of 17. So 17 minus 10 is going to give us a positive 7. Next, on to 9 times 5. Writing out 9 times 5, we get 45. 10 increased by 8. So we're summing 10 and 8 together because we have 10 increased by 8. And 10 plus 8 equals 18. Moving on to number 33, we have 7 squared. So 7 squared, you can think of as 7 times 7. 7 squared equals 49. Now on to our last problem, number 34. The product of 4 and 5. Product, we're going to be multiplying. So 4 times 5 is equivalent to 20. And that's our last solution on this worksheet under the free CUDA Software Infinite Algebra 1 section. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And hopefully for numbers 25 through 34, you could do all that math in your head without using a calculator. If you couldn't, I recommend going back and practicing simple flashcards, going through addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, just to get quicker and more comfortable with numbers, because that will help you in the long run when you have to complete a test or some real-life situation where a calculator is not available. Now, before moving on to the next video, as always, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your peers. For more information, visit my website, maemap.com, maemap.com.